As OnePlus promised that they'll be rolling out stable version for OnePlus 6 and 6T in the month of November. And today it's 2nd November, OnePlus have already started rolling out Android 10 stable version for OnePlus 6 and 6T. So this is my OnePlus 6T, which is now running on the stable build of Oxygen OS, which is 9.0.17. Update is still not available via OTA, but still you can use Oxygen OS updater application. Once you open it, you'll see a new update available, which is Oxygen OS 10.0. which is based on Android 10. They have also put up a message for T-Mobile users. So if you are a owner of T-Mobile, do not try to update via Oxygen OS updater application because this will lead to hardware mismatch. I'll also put up the direct links in the description below so that you guys can directly download the files and do a local upgrade. But make sure to take a backup and also make sure that your device is charged more than 30%. And for those who are running Open Beta 1 on OnePlus 6 and 6T, I'll leave a video link in the description below to downgrade your device to stable build of Oxygen OS. So here the update size is 1802 MB, which is 1.8 GB. And change logs are related to system, full screen gestures, game space, contextual display, and messaging app. So now let's download and install this update. Once the downloading process is completed, it will show you an installation guide. You can just read that, or else you can just follow video guide. So after you have successfully downloaded the file, you need to go to Settings, System, System Update, tap on the gear icon towards the right top corner, select Local Upgrade, and you'll see the file which was downloaded by Oxygen OS updater application. Tap on this and tap Install Now. Once installation process is completed, you can reboot your device. So device have been successfully booted up. Let me show you the software information first by going to Settings, About Phone. And here you can see the Oxygen OS version is now 10.0, which is based on Android 10. Security patch remains 1st October 2019 and the build date is 27th October 2019. Also make sure to format your device after updating to Android 10 for better performance. So after a long time, OnePlus 6 and 6T are also a part of Android 10 now. And after the update, there won't be any kind of data loss if you are doing a local upgrade. As you can see, all my applications and files are available inside the internal storage. Oxygen OS 10.0 brings a new launcher, which is OnePlus Launcher 4.1. A dedicated video will be given in the description below or in the I button. Camera version is now 3.8.75, but there are no major improvements related to camera. First thing you'll notice that there are slight improvements done related to UI, but not a major one. This will be your quick setting panel, which have all the features like Zen mode and screen recorder. This is your volume panel. Tapping on the gear icon will open up options like ringtone and alarm tone. This is your notification panel where you can long press and you get two options. One is important and others. And if you want to completely turn off the notification, you can tap on this and a menu will pop up, in which you can select your options and apply the settings. With Oxygen OS Open Beta 1, there were issues with the gyroscope. But with this update, they have fixed that and now gyroscope works fine. Also, there were issues related to fingerprint scanner setup, but here I don't face any kind of issues in setting up my fingerprint. So fingerprint works fine here. So now let's take a look at the change logs. So these are the change logs in which first one is related to system, which says upgraded to Android 10, which I've already shown you. Brand new UI design, slight improvements are there, not major improvements. They have also enhanced the location permission for privacy. After that, under system, they have also added a new customization feature. So that can be found inside the settings section. Here you have the option to customize your device, where you get three themes available. One is vibrant tint, illuminating, and non-dark. Selecting non-dark will completely turn the UI into dark. Supporting apps will also get adapted to dark theme. Then we have clock styles available, fingerprint animation effects, which consist of Cosmos, Ripple, and Stripe. We also get option to customize the essence color, where you have few options to directly choose the color, and you can also customize as per your requirement. Tone can be changed from colorful, light, and dark. We also get option to change the quick setting tile shape, in which we have rounded, square, teardown, and round rectangle. We have two fonts options, which is Roboto and OnePlus Slate. And the last one under system, it says general bug fixes and improvements have been done. Moving on to the next change log, which says full screen gestures, added inward swipe from left or right edge of the screen to go back, Added a button navigation bar to allow switching left or right from recent app. So here OnePlus have also adapted to the Google navigation gestures, but OnePlus have also retained their full screen gestures. So here you have the Google gestures available in which you can swipe from left or right to go back. And they have also added an bottom navigation bar to swipe from the recent application. If you don't want this bottom bar, you have an option to hide that. Next changelog is related to GameSpace, which says new GameSpace feature now joins all your favorite games in one place. Previously we had the gaming mode option available inside the utilities section, but that has been removed. Now we have a dedicated application called GameSpace, and gaming mode is directly implemented inside this application, where we have features like fanatic mode and options to show the notification. Talking about the next changelog, which is contextual display, which says intelligent info based on your specific time, location, event for ambient display. So for this you need to turn on ambient display first, and here under ambient display you'll see an option of contextual info, which will show music info and upcoming events on the lock screen. And talking about the last changelog, which is related to messaging app, which says now possible to block spam by keywords for messages. For that, open up messaging application. Tap on these three dots, settings, blocking settings, and here you have an option of block by keyword, where you can add any keyword, and if the same keyword appears in any of your messages, that message will be completely blocked. So guys, these are the complete change logs of Oxygen OS 10.0, a new video coming soon in which I'll be showing you top features of Oxygen OS 10.0. So now talking about the benchmark results, with Geekbenchmark application, single core have scored 522 and multi-core have scored 2334. With Antutu benchmark application, device have scored 345,276. So guys, this was all about Android 10, which is based on Oxygen OS 10.0 for OnePlus 6 and 6T. If you still have any kind of questions, you can let me know in the comment section below. This is your friend Ashok signing out. See you guys in the next video.